that there was another way to live, that you didn't have to live like that. What I didn't know was whether I'd still be able to do what I really wanted to do. But I found out that I could.
It is the evening of the day.
By the time I did Strange Weather, I was clean. And I was really much too raw to actually do the work that you have to do to write songs. Because I do have to go into myself and really examine things and work them out. And I just wouldn't have been able to do it and stay clean.
And all over the world, strangers talk only about the weather. All over the world, it's the same, it's the same, it's the same.
Strange Weather was fantastic. To be able to do a whole album of great, great songs that I hadn't had to write, it was wonderful. Because I didn't write them, but I could... I did them as if I had written them. I mean, it's a really great acting job, actually.
Acting would continue to be a refuge. Marianne returned to the stage in a production of Brecht and Weill's Threepenny Opera. In a way, it was a lifeline.
You can kindly throw me pennies and I thank you very much. You see me ragged and tattered in this dirty shit hotel. You don't know in hell who's talking.
It was at a very crucial time. It was just after my mother died. My mother had just died. I flew back from the funeral to start rehearsals on the Threepenny Opera. So again, I was in an amazingly sort of wounded, raw state.
You still don't know in hell who's talking. Yet one fine day there will be roars from the harbour, and you'll ask what is all that screeching for. And you'll see me smiling as I dunk the glasses, and you'll say, what's she got to smile at for?
And of course it also got me much more, much deeper into my obsession with Kurt Weill, which led to making the Weimar Cabaret record, 20th Century Blues, and now the Seven Deadly Sins. And that's using symbolic power to a proper effect, I think. Marianne Faithfull sings the Seven Deadly Sins is good.
My recollection.
Clean of her heroin habit and working again, her father's life project, Brazier's College, drew her back. It was time to face up to an unresolved relationship.
There's no question that a little girl's first great love is her father. And in my case, it certainly was. I just worshipped him. I adored my parents. But of course, the great heartbreak was when my mother left my father. And I lost my father, really, after that. And I only found him again in the last 5 years. And he died in February. So it's very emotional for me. And I sometimes think that's even the reason for all this stuff with Mick. That the only love I really understand of the masculine figure is unrequited. Because that's such an important relationship. That until the very end of his life was never really fulfilled, me and my dad.
Stories.
people have been starting to make wonderful, really dark records, and this is my specialty. And it cheered me up, and I decided, well, okay, if they want to see how to make a really dark record, I'll make one. And I did.
Lying on the living room floor, on those Indian tapestry cushions you made, thinking of calling our firstborn Jasmine or Jade.
Of course, it was hard work. I had to write the songs. I had to really go in there. But it was okay. I was safe. I didn't have to take heroin. I didn't have to lose my mind. I didn't have to even take Prozac. I was okay.
My riches can't buy everything.
Yes, you know, we're grandparents. What can I say? I'm a granddad and she's a grandma. And we have two grandchildren.
I thank God for Nicholas and his children. And Nicholas and Carol are really sweet to me. Nicholas particularly understands me and knows my rather complicated position, which I have in fact have painted myself into.
Marianne as a person is not the Marianne Faithful that we hear on records or we think of as the mythological character. She's almost like the caretaker of her own legend, and that creation in itself, that creation of Marianne Faithful, is her greatest work of art.
Well, not just because she's a survivor. I mean, we all are. Everybody you meet is. It's not as corny as that. I mean, she's a pain in the butt a lot of the time, still. But, I mean, that's part of Marianne. But at the same time, she's very warm and very giving and very generous of spirit. And clothes, I came in her old coat, didn't I?
I sit and watch as tears go by.
All my songs are about me. It's trying to explain or to show people that that although somebody doesn't make the choices you would understand, that doesn't mean they are the wrong choices for them.
She's got some guts, that girl. Apart from a great pair, too. Love you, darling.
I am an adventuress, and I have lived my life as an adventure. And it's been rather wonderful. And I really wouldn't change much about it, so I have to stand by it. I do stand by it.
Thank you. This is really great.